Hello everyone, today I want to talk a little bit about the use of preferences when drawing. It is a very controversial topic to some, so I want to make clear that everyone has the right to their own opinion. Personally though, I am a big fan of references. For me it makes drawings and paintings more interesting if you can see a bit of influence in them, but more importantly, it's the best way to learn and also helps a lot to improve your results. So for this painting I used some stock material from Storyblocks, who are sponsoring this video. You can get all the stock images you can imagine from Storyblocks, including high quality photos, vectors, icons and more. They have over 400,000 images in their member library and you can save 60% on marketplace content. They're giving away 7 free days so you can try it out and access a wide variety of high resolution photos, vectors and more. Click the link in the description below to start downloading and get started today. For this painting I took one photo as a base, added some flowers and vectorized plants. That way I have a final composition on paper that I can turn into a watercolor painting, and I don't have to work towards a goal blindly. As you can see, I was a bit more creative with the face and some other things in my pencil sketch, which is just the benefit of being able to draw freely, in contrast to work for a client for example. But more on that topic later. I think everyone has had their own experience with references at some point in their life as artists, especially when uploading their work online. May they be good or bad. For me it has been quite an up and down to be honest. When I started drawing, I usually just copied from manga books like Naruto. On the website where I uploaded them, you had to label them properly, which I think is just the best way to deal with work like that. At that time I was learning to draw and of course I got a bit braver and experimented. At some point I wasn't just copying, but taking, let's say, the pose and expression of a character and drew another character with those, like you can see here with Naruto and Kingdom Hearts. Anyway, you can see things got a bit more complicated at that point. In a way it was copied, but also it wasn't since there was no picture like that before. In the end, I didn't have to mark it as copied on the website. But I think it was also due to me being too small of an artist and too few people would actually have cared. Still, I think this summarizes the essence of why using references is seen as controversial. One group would emphasize the alleged theft of the source material and others might look at what was done as an addition to the source material, and both are somewhat right. With a Naruto-based drawing I would say the copy aspect is more obvious to the eye. Looking back on this piece I would say it's expressing nothing more but hi, I am a fan of both series, which is totally fine especially considering my age and my simple intention being exactly that. I continue drawing, sometimes using references subtly and sometimes more obviously, which luckily was rarely part of any arguments for a long time, but cases of reference work getting bashed became more frequent on that website. There was something comparable to daily deviations, and if an artwork got featured where source material got dug up by other users, it got taken down and there was a lot of hate. And I'm not talking about obvious reference usage like that Kingdom Hearts fanart, but of artwork where somebody used reference photos for minute details. It had become almost some kind of witch hunt trying to expose and ruin the reputation of famous German artists. Around that time there were a bunch of, let's call them, elitists that would proclaim you can only achieve true originality if you fully abandon references. They would talk about how it was a question of honor of a true artist to not stick to references for too long, but to draw anything from your mind. The old masters wouldn't have done it any other way, they said. To which I say that's just simply wrong. You can argue against the use of reference out of your personal opinions or convictions, but reference have been part of art since the beginning. Da Vinci dug up corpses for God's sake, to have proper material to work from. The fact that people use references, looked at their environment or were inspired by the work of other people, actually is a major help to quickly estimate date and origin of old unsigned artwork. So when an old oil painting of an unknown artist appears, art historians analyze the motif, the way faces and clothes and trees were painted. This way they roughly figure out when and where it probably was done, because they compare it with paintings that are better known, which share the same features. Here's an example. This woodcut is similar in style and appearance to another woodcut we have more information about. So it gives art historians the possibility to classify the image without having to wait for chemical analysis. That said, style analysis often is just a rough instrument in order to estimate the time of creation, since it was believed both were done around the same time, but the age of the paper showed that the first woodcut actually was used as reference for the other one around 70 years later. But again, that is only one example. The thing with references is, sometimes there's a fine line between plain copying and making something your own. So when you look at cases like the work of Dürer compared to what Raimondi did 4 years later, a lot of people might question the originality of Raimondi's work, because there were only few transformations. On the other hand, if you take Warhol's soup cans or Lichtenstein's comic panels that undeniably share just as strong of a resemblance to their source material, more people might argue that their work is original, because they take the context in consideration. But don't get me wrong here, with this video I'm not trying to generally defend or trash the use of references. I just want to demonstrate that it's not a black and white issue. Sure, for some people it might seem like using references is a cheat or some easy way out that only bad artists use while two idols create everything out of their head. To which I respond, often you just cannot tell, only assume. And if you have to assume anyway, why not rather assume references were used than thinking none were involved? That way one doesn't end up disappointed by artists because an assumption was proven wrong that wasn't true in the first place. Videos like Everything's a Remix demonstrate that mutual inspiration is far more common than an isolated artist that creates 100% original work. Depending on how you use references, it effectively is not the easiest way at all. References don't necessarily make a drawing easier, because besides the creativity, a lot of research and preparation needs to go into your work. You also have to have a certain amount of competence already. One of the most common ways is taking photos of your own hands to add them to the drawing of your character. You have to have parts of your drawing done already, or at least a picture of it in your head to match the pose of your hand towards it. And even then, it doesn't mean the hands will turn out well through the use of references alone. It's like thinking a Russian Photoshop will solve all your problems in digital art. But let's talk about some more complicated work. Imagine you are doing an art trade and you are asked to draw an already existing character with highly detailed and elaborate clothing. You could draw it the way you think it looks like, or you actually do some research and figure out what defines that character. For that, references are mandatory, to make the character recognizable, and sometimes it is even more work than just drawing things out of your head. Another example. Imagine drawing a car without having a car to look at. It would take days of studying to remember how that car would look like properly in order to be able to bring it to paper. And even then, you technically were not able to avoid references, you were just able to keep them in mind. And I could go on with tributes, live drawing sessions or studies in general, but I think you get the idea. In the end, it comes down to how you use and how you deal with the use of references. It's just like with music. You can do a cover, a remix or use single samples to create something new. That's up to you. It's not the magic spell to become a pro artist overnight that some might believe it to be. Yes, it can come close to copying, but it doesn't have to. It offers possibilities to realize ideas and process new concepts. With some projects, it's even mandatory. And even your own experiences serves as reference for your work to a certain extent. References are a tool, and depending on your current project, you might use it or not. I mean, there's a reason why reference books, anatomy figurines, or stock photos exist. They provide source material to work with. So, what do you think? How much do you make use of references and what are your experience on this topic? If you enjoyed this video and the painting, leave a like. Also, my artbook is back in stock. If you're interested, check out my Etsy shop in the description. Thank you for watching and I hope to see you next time.